The next concept we are discussing in this lesson is accuracy and precision. Precision. These two are not same. These two are different in the view of physics. So what is the meaning of accuracy? Suppose an experiment was done. Let us suppose the experiment was done to find the g of a body, or g, acceleration due to gravity. We will use a simple pendulum. We used to calculate the oscillations. From that oscillations, we will calculate the time and time period. We will plot the graph between the length of the pendulum to the square of the time period. And directly we will substitute that L by T square value in the formula 4 pi square into L by T square. Now we will get the G value. This results the acceleration due to gravity. We know this. But what is the meaning of accuracy? What is this whole information is needed to explain this? Yes, accuracy means if a value was measured, or if a value was found in during an experiment, that value is how much close to the original. That is said to be accuracy. G value is 9.8 meters per second. We know this. Suppose during this experiment, suppose 10 trials, find the average. The average value he got is some 9.6 meters per second. Some we can write 9.62 meters per second square. This 9.62 is almost very close to 9.8. Suppose if the answer is 9 or 9.1, then this case it is not acceptable with respect to the given values. So what we can understand is this value, what we have got in the experiment, is how much close to the original. That is said to be accuracy. The value that obtained during an experiment is how much close to the original value. This is called accuracy of the experiment. The next one is precision. Precision is dependent on the physical device. How much extent or how much least value that we can measure by using a physical device is called precision. How much least value or how much least extent that we can measure by using a physical device is called precision of that instrument, of the instrument. This accuracy of an experiment is very acceptable by minimizing the precisions. That means if you see vernier calipers, it can measure up to 0.1 centimeter. Screw gauge 0.01 centimeter. Means their ability to find the least values, lowest of the least, is increasing. It is able to find 1 by 10, it is able to find 0, 1 by 100 also. Which one? The screw gauge. So we can say the screw gauge has highest precision. That means the value what we can obtain to find the thickness of the body is very much close when we measured with the screw gauge. So like this we can able to find the correct answers with the help of the physical devices that we are available with us. The next one is true or most accurate value and errors. So we can write this one as errors. So what is the meaning of true or most accurate? Suppose while we are repeating the experiment for several times, sometimes their arithmetic mean or absolute error may be positive or negative. So some 6 trials of an experiment, we got some average value. If we do the subtraction of that individual value minus average value, we will get the absolute error. This absolute error, sometimes it is positive or negative. So to eliminate this absolute error, the best way to get the true or most accurate value is finding the average out of it. If number of trials are more than 8, then we will get most accurate answer. Number of trials should be more than 8. That is the point we should note. And at the same time, what we can understand in this concept is, if this number of trials are increasing, then the value what we can obtain is also increasing or moving towards the accurate value. So number of trials is directly proportional to the accurate value. That means accurate value is directly proportional to the number of trials. This point should be noted while we are doing or finding the true or most accurate values. So what is the arithmetic mean? Sum of observations by number of observations. So we can write this one like this: x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus so on xn by n. So this one can be written like this also: summation over sigma xn by n, where n is equal to 1 to n. Or we can write xi by n, where I is equal to 1 to n. So this is the way to find out the arithmetic mean. So number of trials should be increases to find the most accurate values. The next one is absolute error. So what is the meaning of absolute error? Yes, we have to take some trials to find the answer up to some an. These all values, we will find the arithmetic mean also. What is the general definition of the absolute error? The value what we find minus true value is called absolute error. The obtained value minus true value is called absolute error. Let us suppose the obtained value is A1, true value is A. This A1 minus A, we can say delta A1. The difference between the obtained value in an experiment to its true value is called absolute error. Next, A2 minus A delta A2. Like this, A3 minus A delta A3. Like this, we can say AN minus A delta AN. Now for all these absolute errors, we should find the arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean of absolute errors. So delta A1 plus delta A2 and so on, delta AN by n.
These are called the average or arithmetic mean of the absolute error. So the value what we will get by doing the arithmetic mean of or finding the arithmetic mean of absolute errors is called mean absolute error. So we will get delta A bar is arithmetic mean of absolute errors. Therefore, delta A bar is equal to delta A1 plus delta A2 plus delta A3 plus delta AN and so on, delta AN by N. So this can be written as summation over delta AI, where I is equal to 1 to N by N. This is equal to delta A bar. Now, from this information, we can find two types of errors. First one is relative error. Relative error means the ratio between the delta A bar by arithmetic mean of the absolute errors. Where delta A bar is the arithmetic mean of absolute errors, where A mean is arithmetic mean of all the values what we find in the experiment, or arithmetic mean of obtained values. So this is called delta A by A mean. In other words, we can write this one as delta A bar by A. This is said to be a relative error. This mean of the arithmetic mean of the absolute errors, or the difference between the true value minus real value, is always positive. The next one what you can find out is percentage error. Where percentage error is equal to relative error into 100. Into 100%. So where relative error is equal to delta A bar by A mean into 100%. The acceptable percentage error in an experiment is plus or minus 5%. That means in an experiment, if you get a value of 100, the acceptable values are from 95 to 105. If the value exceeds 105, or if the values is less than 95, then we should think about the repetition of the experiment, because acceptable is plus or minus 5%, because many factors will act on the experiment to give the error in the result. So this is the style we should follow to find the percentage error and relative error and acceptability.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.